Hi, Max Brantley with the Arkansas Times on Wednesday, March the 21st. Well, the news today is all about medical marijuana. Circuit Judge Wendell Griffin ruled this morning that indeed, as a lawsuit alleged, the Medical Marijuana Commission hadn't fully complied with all the rules and regulations governing its work, and that no permit should be issued for cultivation of medical marijuana in Arkansas under the recent scoring that was just completed and listed five companies at the top of the list for those who should get permits. He found several problems. He said the commission hadn't validated itself of the rule that requires a certain distance between cultivation facilities and schools and churches. He said that it appeared they hadn't fully considered a rule about people involved in medical marijuana facilities having had records of not paying past franchise taxes. But the biggest issue, I think, was his finding that two members of the commission had conflicts of interest. Travis Story, a lawyer from Fayetteville who graded the scores, had one top score who had been a legal client of his. Carlos Roman, a doctor from Little Rock, who does professional work with one of the owners of one of the successful cultivation permit applicants, also decided on the permits. He said that the commission not only must be unbiased, it must appear to be unbiased, and therefore he issued a preliminary injunction, said that the award of the five permits was null and void. What happens next, we don't really know. We're waiting for word from the Attorney General's office on whether they'll appeal Griffin's ruling or tell the commission they need to go back and start over. There's a new call for people to find an outside independent arbitrator to do the scoring, say a national accounting firm. This idea came up early in the process, and there was some thought originally that this work couldn't be delegated under Arkansas law, so we still have a lot of questions about what happens next. What we do know is there is a delay. If there's nobody to grow marijuana, there's no marijuana for dispensaries to get a supply from and to sell it to people, so people are looking for it. Are not going to have it. The judge said that it was unpleasant that people are going to have to wait longer because of this ruling, but the rule of law counted. A lot of people are going to criticize the judge for talking about the appearance of bias because, you know, he's in the middle of a huge controversy deciding a case that had at least a relationship to the death penalty, something that he's protested against, and his own bias or appearance of bias has been raised as an issue in some of his own business. Well, Senator Tom Cotton today recommended that people read a tough opinion piece in the Wall Street Journal that says you can't just talk to Vladimir Putin, we've got to get tough with him. This comes after his great ally, Donald Trump, yesterday called Putin and, against the advice of his counselors, congratulated Putin on his victory in the recent Russian election, which may or may not have been a real election victory. Trump likes Russia a lot, and so does Tom Cotton, in fact. He's been tied, and several people have pointed out today, the money he paid to Cambridge Analytics to work in his campaign and the money he received from the Mercer family's backers of Cambridge Analytics in his race for U.S. Senate. More reporting today on ties between Cambridge Analytics and Russian scientists and their election hacking work. So there's Tom Cotton. Is he for Russia or is he against? Don't go necessarily just by what he says. Stacey Hurst, the director of the State Department of Arkansas Heritage, announced today that she'd chosen Wendy Richter, a professor at Washita Baptist University, to be the next Arkansas historian and state archivist. She succeeds Lisa Speer. Speer resigned after having difficulties getting along with Stacey Hurst, not alone in that category. A lot of people have criticized Hurst for forcing Speer out and for some of her other decisions. Richter has been state archivist previously. A state legislative commission is looking at the tax policy in Arkansas, looking at ways to raise revenue and to save money by tax cuts. And yesterday they came back to an oldie but a goodie that's always popular with Arkansas legislators. And do we really need to do away with the last penny or so still remaining on groceries and the state sales tax? It's supposed to go away next year. They want to hold on to that money, perhaps even bring back the other sales tax on poor people's groceries because, of course, they want to cut the income tax for rich people. Oh, there's another good idea out there that's actually not that bad, and that's to put the state sales tax on motor fuels. This would be an elastic tax that would produce a lot of money for highways from people who actually use the highways rather than robbing general revenues. It's, in fact, too good an idea for this legislature to approve, I think almost certainly. Well, the state hospital is on the lookout for both a staff psychologist and a patient. Michelle Messer, a psychologist, helped a patient, Corey Chapin, walk away from the unit yesterday, the forensic unit here in Little Rock, and they're still being searched for. They say they'll fire the psychologist if they ever find her again. Chapin has been under treatment of one sort of closely supervised or in lockdown, as he was lately, after he was found innocent by reason of mental disease and defect of an attempted kidnapping of a woman in Carroll County, Eureka Springs, several years ago. He was recaptured in Las Vegas last year after being on the loose for most of the year after eloping, to use the word the state hospital uses, from a center in Corning, Arkansas. Well, the face of terrorism in America turns out to be a 23-year-old white male, a homeschool young man from Texas, who wrote on his political blog when he was a community college student that he was a conservative and didn't think much about homosexuality and gay marriage, but he did believe in the death penalty. Well, he blew himself up in a car in Texas this morning as police closed in. He's believed to be the person responsible for a string of bombings in the Austin area. Is he a terrorist like the ones the president talks about so much? He certainly terrorized Austin, Texas. And finally, we're still talking about a school shooting incident, this one in Maryland. Senator Trent Garner of Arkansas, who thinks there are not enough guns everywhere to keep us all safe, says that the incident in Maryland showed that more guns and more hands will put a stop to mass shootings, period, was how he put it. Well, a school resource officer did react bravely and quickly to a shooting in a school in Maryland. He came up and fired a shot. It's not yet clear whether his shot killed a school shooter or the school shooter shot himself. One other student was injured critically, and another one was wounded not so severely. It clearly didn't stop a mass shooting there. Three students were shot, but he brought an end to it, perhaps, and that's a good thing. But do we really want to have guns in the hands of teachers? Trent Garner thinks so. I'm not sure the Maryland shooting is a case for anything. They're still investigating who shot whom in that incident. Sometimes even police officers' shots go astray. Lots of things to resist in this world and to think about carefully. I'm Max Brantley. I'll be back tomorrow.